After the gametes, they have been formed. The structure of the gametes is there. That is, again, you can get to have the question on the labeling part of, as we have studied for the reproductive systems, वैसे ही आपका gametes के ऊपर भी labeling जो है वो आ सकता है. Sometimes you also get to have ABCD unlabeled parts आपको दे दिए जाएंगे, और उन unlabeled parts में भी आपको बोलते हैं कि let's say B part का function क्या है, which of the following have been a has been shown as a function of the B part, let's say कोई भी part है ना, तो ऐसा function आपको आ जाएगा. यहाँ आपसे क्वेश्चन आ सकता है कि जैसे आपको कोई भी पार्ट्स दे दिए हैं, एंड देन दे आर आस्किंग यू टू फाइंड द क्लियर एंड अ करेक्ट मैच. मैच कैसा, जैसे आपको पार्ट दिया है और उसके साथ उसका फंक्शन दिया है, ठीक है, समथिंग लाइक दैट, उसके जैसा कुछ आपका क्वेश्चन जो है वो बनेगा. सो दिस इज लाइक समथिंग यू विल बी गेटिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू योर डायग्राम्स एज वेल. सो नीड नॉट टू से कि हम लोगों ने डायग्राम्स नहीं करने हैं, या हमने डायग्राम्स छोड़ देने हैं, हमने ओवरलुक कर देने. यू आर टू लुक द डायग्राम्स प्रॉपरली, एंड ऑल्सो द डायग्राम्स विच आर देयर इन योर एनसीईआरटी स्पेशली, ठीक है, एनसीईआरटी वाले स्पेशली डायग्राम्स जो है अच्छे से देखना, क्योंकि आपके पेपर में अगर क्वेश्चन आता है स्कैंड क्वेश्चन, जो मतलब डायग्राम स्कैंड आएगा, तो वो एनसीईआरटी से प्रेफरेबली आएगा. और अदरवाइज इफ आई विल बी ड्रॉइंग, तो मे बी आई कैन ड्रॉ इट एज आई हैव डन इट ऑलरेडी इन योर क्लास, ठीक है. सो अकॉर्डिंगली यू हैव टू लेबल द पार्ट्स, राइट, बट द पार्ट्स लेबलिंग विल ऑल्सो बी दैट फ्रॉम योर एनसीईआरटी ओनली. एनसीईआरटी में जितना गिवन है उतने में से ही आएगा, ठीक है जी. So coming to this, that is the gametes, two gametes are there, that is the male and the female gamete. So the structure first of the sperm cell or a male gamete, that has the main structure as the animal cell, that is its head, head portion is there, one second. There is head portion, along with that, there is at the tip of the head, there is a sac of enzymes. And what is that sac of enzymes called as? It is acrosome, है ना? That which helps in the dissolving of the or the dissolution of the male gametes की जो entry है, उसमें ये penetration में help करता है, and dissolution of the corona radiata type of the layers of the female gamete. They will be dissolved easily with the help of these enzymes packed over the tip of the head. So this forms the acrosome. This is the acrosome. This is an animal structure, animal cell-like structure, completely having all the cell organelles. The centrioles are arranged within this neck piece, right? There is a centriole. The centrioles are arranged here, and the middle piece is this one middle piece that has the enriched, you can say, enriched structure that made up of the mitochondria. This is the tail or the flagella that which helps in the movement of the male gametes, right? So herein. What is happening is from the centrioles there arises a axis. This creates an axial filament that which runs along the full length like this till the tip. Okay, forming the tail, pointing tail, right? This provides a stiffness also to the structure. That is the axial filament arising from the centriole. Then there are the mitochondria which are present only in the middle piece. These gives the energy. Sometimes you get to have a question like energy कहाँ से मिलता है इसको? वो जो energy देने वाला structure है वो कहाँ पे associated है? Which of the following parts? Head, neck, middle piece, tail. तो mitochondria, these are the mitochondria. They are associated with the middle piece of the male gamete, right? So these are the various parts, the flagella and the tail. This is the structure of the sperm cell, right? So labeling में भी आपको पता होना चाहिए. This is the head region. Then this is the neck region. Then this is middle piece having the mitochondria in it. These are the centrioles. ये centrioles हैं जो कि axial filament बनाते हैं. ये सारा filament है. This is the axial filament. And this is the tail. Tail वैसे पूरा है, but this is the pointing end of the tail, right? Having the flagellar movements that which helps it to be motile and that which helps it to go to the female gamete, right? Now, what is a female gamete structure? Female gamete is a ova. Ova structure that consists of further the ova that has its own cell. First of all, the cell of the ova that is very specific in its structure, as it has number one the outer membrane, that is the outer membrane of the ova is termed specifically as the ulema. ठीक है, जो इसकी membrane है, इस cell की जो membrane है, उसको ulema बोलते हैं. और जो फ्लूइड है इसका, दैट इज द साइटोप्लाज्म ऑफ दिस ओवा सेल, and the nucleus is here. The fluid is specially called as ooplasm, not the cytoplasm, but specifically called as a ooplasm. Around this, there is a layer, single layer deposition of zona pellucida, and there is a thick layer around the zona pellucida, that of the corona radiata. So this is the zona pellucida. In between, there is a perivitelline space. Ye jo beech mein space hai, that is a perivitelline space and zona pellucida. And around it, there is a corona radiata, that which makes a thick covering around the ova. So is tarah se ye thick covering around the ova hai. When the male gamete has to pass in, jab ye usko apna fusion dena hai, fertilization dena hai, it has to first invade through this thick layer of the corona radiata. ठीक है, फर्स्ट थिक लेयर ऑफ द कोरोना रेडिएटा से पास इन करने के लिए इट हैज अ एक्रोसोम. सो एक्रोसोम से विद द हेल्प ऑफ द एक्रोसोमल रिएक्शंस ओनली इट विल बी पेनिट्रेटिंग इनसाइड, दैट इज अ कोरोना रेडिएटा से अंदर होते हुए जाएगा. देन इट गोज एंड फ्यूजेस टुवर्ड्स दिस जोना प्लूसिडा, देन पेनिट्रेटिंग एंड फ्यूजिंग आउट दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया. ये जब पूरा का पूरा एरिया इसने पेनिट्रेशन में दे दिया, देन फाइनली the whole cell mass will be left outside. The cell mass is not going to enter. What is going to enter is its only nucleus. Nucleus goes and enters into the ova. Okay, so there the fertilization takes place. This is the concept of the fertilization. When it penetrates the two layers of the ova, that are the corona radiata and the second is the zona pellucida. And these are also accompanied by the two of the polar bodies. Total of three polar bodies banti hain jab hum oogenesis padhte hain, pura concept padhte hain, because we know meiosis se resultant banni hai hamare paas gametes ki. Meiosis jab ho jati hai, final complete hoti hai, so structures jo bante hain, that is the secondary oocyte along with the polar bodies, and a total of four cells kitne kaun se banenge, three polar bodies and one of the ova. Theek hai, jo one yahan se banega, that will be the ovum, ova, right? Total of three polar bodies. Pehli division se, pehli meiosis se one polar body, one secondary oocyte, aur jab dusra hoga to one polar body se bhi aage two polar bodies and this oocyte again. Theek hai, sorry, this ovum again, right? So ye kya hai, this is in total forming the three of the polar bodies, but teen polar bodies mein ek polar body jo hai differentiate karke further do aur bana rahi hai. Polar bodies ka role kya hai, that is unknown till now. But otherwise, it is seen as the two of the tiny granular structures present in the perivitelline space, and the function of the polar bodies is thought to be ki jahan pe ye polar bodies present hoti hain, wahi se jo male gamete aa raha hota hai wo penetrate karta hai andar. Theek hai, that is maybe that has not been full proved, but otherwise it has been mentioned that it is a thought of this polar bodies function. That wheresoever in the perivitelline space there will be the polar body's presence, only the one male gamete penetrating through this side that will be fertilizing with the ova, but the others they will be degenerating, right? Many of the male gametes, they reach up to this and they degenerate, right? So this is the process of the fertilization, and the fertilization takes place after ovulation into the fallopian tube, ampulla, isthmus junction pe jab ye dono male and female gamete present hote hain, then it starts penetrating and undergoes the fertilization. As a result, what is the new structure which is created? It is called as a zygote. As a result, the structure newly created is called as a zygote. The zygote then further undergoes many cleavages, or the, you can say, repetitive divisions. That is only mitotic divisions, not the meiosis one. Meiosis ho gaya yahan pe khatam. Mitosis divisions ke baad bahut sari number of the stages aayengi, and finally a blastocyst which is going to fix into the uterine wall, right? For understanding briefly this whole step and all the you can say steps in between, there is a video, I am just sharing it, and when we will, after that video we will again continue this particular process of implantation and the fertilization, right? So let me just share that video with you, and just put your thumbs up if you see it and if you hear it properly. Okay, Anji beta, is this visible to you people? Okay, and audibility also you tell me, right? One second. Anji, is this audible?
Yes.
Is it audible? I think I need to enhance the audio. The audio is this much only. Was this audible, Tushar? Can you please?
He's looking at the events of fertilization, and we'll talk about early embryonic development and implantation, as well as embryonic and fetal development and then hormonal changes in pregnancy. So we're going to be covering all four topics. So in fertilization usually that's what we want. It's not likely to take place in the UF2, okay, as I mentioned in previous video lectures. Sperm have to be introduced into the female reproductive tract within 5 days before ovulation. All right. The sperm are viable for 5 days, and the secondary oocyte is viable for 12 to 24 hours. So the sperm actually, they're initially incapable of fertilization, and they become capable of fertilization through a process called capacitation. So what capacitation is, it's where actually the tail or the flagellum of the sperm moves faster. So that actually increases motility. And the plasma membrane of the sperm is altered. And it's altered in such a manner that it can fuse with the secondary oocyte. Let's just look at sort of a pictorial view of what we were just talking about. So we've already talked about how the secondary oocyte gets produced in the ovary. And we've mentioned that it takes it 4 days to get to the uterus. So while it's traveling through that uterine tube, it may encounter sperm. So the sperm have to enter through the female reproductive tract. So I'm using a blue color for sperm. And the sperm have to encounter the secondary oocyte. And that's where fertilization takes place. Okay. So, like I said earlier, timing is everything, right? Okay, so fertilization takes place in the uterine tube. Remember that implantation takes place in the uterus. All right, so here's how this process happens. So we're gonna look at sperm penetration of the secondary oocyte. So how does the sperm penetrate? So there's a whole bunch of sperm that actually reach the ovum. Remember that for every ejaculation, there's anywhere from 50 to 500 million sperm that get released. So that means a whole bunch of sperm can actually reach the ovum. So once they do reach the ovum, and let's actually write secondary oocyte here because that's actually a more correct term. So when the secondaries or when the sperm reach the secondary oocyte, this is when the acrosomal reaction begins. So the acrosomal reaction begins where a whole bunch of enzymes get released and the enzymes start breaking through the zone of pellucida. And so here you can see in step two, all right, the enzymes that are being released. So you can see how that red area is indicating that. And then we have step three, breaking through the zone of pellucida. Okay, because remember these have to penetrate into the egg. So now, sperm have gained entry into your secondary oocyte. Once they've gained entry into the secondary oocyte, the first sperm to bind to the receptor on the oocyte wins. That's the one that fertilizes the egg. Okay, it's got to bind to the receptor, however. Once that happens, the sperm can get transported to the cytoplasm of the oocyte. And then the zona pellucida will harden, and that prevents what's called polyspermy. So you don't want multiple sperm fertilizing eggs. This picture will look familiar to you once again. So now where we are in this diagram, remember this was the diagram of oogenesis. We are at this level here, after fertilization now. So that is stimulated meiosis II. Fertilization stimulates meiosis II. That's where then we go from a secondary oocyte to an ovum. So the sperm plasma membrane then disintegrates. The chromosomes from the sperm and from the ovum migrate to the center. And now we have a zygote. So from that fertilized egg then, the zygote is going to start developing. So remember where we are, we're in the uterine tube. Here's the zygote, which is the fertilized ovum. Now that zygote is going to undergo mitosis. And when it undergoes mitosis, the result is a four-cell stage.
Then it's going to undergo mitosis again. All right. And then it will become a morula. So a morula is literally a solid ball of cells. If you look at this image, it's nothing more than a solid ball of cells. That morula then will undergo more development, and it will develop into a blastocyst. A blastocyst is essentially a hollow ball of cells. Here's a little area that's got some cells, and the rest of this, the blastocele, is actually hollow. The trophoblast will actually, it'll eventually become the placenta, or help form part of the placenta at least. It's at this time that that blastocyst becomes an actual embryo. So with the blastocyst, the reason we're saying that this becomes an embryo is that the cells begin to differentiate. What I mean by the cells beginning to differentiate is that they're now committed to becoming certain types of tissues. Maybe they're committed to becoming neural tissue, or maybe they're committed to becoming muscle tissue, and so on. Then finally, here we have implantation at day 6 post-fertilization. And the trophoblast is also very important, or plays a role in implantation. Okay, so a lot of times we get the question, well, how are
this is not there as for the twins and everything, but otherwise I think the concepts of the fertilization and implantations are clear to you, right? Implantation se pehle jaise isne blastocyst banaya, also they are mentioning the days. Right. If the days are mentioned in your NCERT books, then definitely they will be there as an MCQ, because then you can also have a question like on the match the column type of a question. Match the column mein beta kya hoga ki aapko jaise days de diye hain, you are given the days like on 1st to 4 days, then 5 to 6 days, aisa aisa hai na, and then you are given the menstrual cycle mein bhi ye ho sakta hai, ya implantation wagera feature mein bhi, if it is given day wise, if it is given in your NCERTs, because your paper will be thoroughly from the NCERT, right? So agar aapka NCERT mein given hai ye concept, to match the column mein aa sakti hai, but always match the column will not be if you are having 4 questions and 4 options will be there. No, that was when you were kids, right? Tab hota tha aisa, ab aisa nahi hoga. If there is a match the column, you will be having 4 questions and 8 of the answers. Ho sakta hai usme se koi ek question ke liye hi 2 options ho, theek hai? To us hisab se aapke jo answer options hai wo bani padi hongi, and you will be giving the further concepts on those basis, right? So this was the concept of the implantation, the male and the female gamete, the implantation that which he has studied. And also now we are going to discuss for the next 5-7 minutes they are left. So I'm going to switch on to the assertion reason which we left yesterday, right? Further after implantation, jo implantation ho jata hai blastocyst level pe, ye humne kal bhi discuss kar liya tha waise. To jo implantation ho jata hai beta, uske baad aage further membranous jo formation hai, yani differentiation, she also wrote something in the video that the cells, they undergo the differentiation for the formation of fetus. But jab differentiation hoti hai na, to hamare paas wo layers banni shuru ho jati hain jo aap logo ne pehle padhi thi, that is a mesodermal, endodermal and the outer exodermal jo layers hain, wo differentiation sabse pehle wo banti hain. Fir mesodermal layers jo hoti hai, that starts forming the organs. These kind of the changes, they are not enlisted in your book, so we are not to go with that, right? Directly after implantation, there is a formation of the fetus, and then the last, that is a menstrual cycle, okay? So we will be switching on to the fetus and the formation and the ejaculation, that is parturition of the fetus. But now we are going to study for some of the assertion reason questions, then we will going to will be going to that particular portion of your this chapter, right? So now let us start with the discussion of the assertion reason. One second, I'm going to share the screen again with you people. Just a minute. Anji, just one second, beta.